Hello everyone. This video is a continuation of the series of problems we've been solving on quadratic equations. The first problem we solved specifically was the solution of a quadratic equation using the factor method. If you want to see the video, kindly click on the top right-hand corner of the screen and it's going to get you to the video. Now, we are going to be solving the same problem in the previous video using the quadratic formula. Here is the problem. Solve x squared minus 5x minus 14 equal to 0. But before venturing into this, what exactly is the quadratic formula? So the quadratic formula is x equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. So this formula helps us to obtain the solutions of a quadratic equation, and of course we know that it can be written in the form ax squared plus bx plus c equal to 0. So the first thing we need to watch out for is to see if this equation is equal to 0. And that condition has been satisfied. The next thing is going to be to obtain the values of these coefficients. The coefficient of x squared, which is a, the coefficient of x, which is b, and the constant, that's the number without an x beside it, which is c. So comparing that, we would see that a is equal to 1, because 1 is the coefficient of x squared. B is equal to a negative 5, because that's the coefficient of x. And c is equal to negative 14. Perfect. So next step, substituting the values of this coefficient into the equation, we've got a negative b. That's going to be a negative negative 5, because we've got a negative beside the b. So here is a negative and b is negative 5, then a plus or a minus the square root of b squared. That's a minus 5 squared, then minus 4ac, a is 1, and c is negative 14. So this is negative 14, then divided by 2a, a is 1, that's 2 times 1. Okay, so this is equal to minus minus 5 is a positive 5. Plus or minus, minus 5 squared, that's minus 5 times minus 5, so that gives 25. Minus 4 times 1 is minus 4, times minus 14 is going to give positive 56. So all over 2 times 1 is 2. So this is looking good. So this is 5 plus or minus, 25 plus 56. Is 81 divided by 2. So this is equal to 5 plus or minus. The square root of 81 is 9. Okay, so this is where the plus or minus is going to come into effect. So this is going to be equal to 5 plus 9 over 2, or 5 minus 9 over 2. So this is where the positive and negative comes into play. So 5 plus 9 is 14, that's over 2. 5 minus 9 is a negative 4 over 2. So therefore we see that the solutions of this quadratic equation is x equal to 7 or x equal to negative 2. And we find that this tallies with what we got when we solve this same problem using the factor method. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, kindly like, subscribe, and share it. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.